Welcome to another episode of Hard Pass New Music Review. Hard Pass Count.
I'm Kyle's with a K.
I'm Travy, but you gotta say it two times and let's count up.
We're here, man.
What'd you listen to, man?
Everything. Did you listen to PinkPantheress? One of these was a single that was in New Music. You get down on one knee because you only want to hold me when I'm looking good enough. First, I didn't like it. And I was like, ugh. Every time I pull my hair, was any
outfit that you find me ugly and one day. It's kind of a vibe, I think.
Yeah, she's nice. Did you ever want me? Was I ever good enough? But boys are layered. The boys are layered. He doesn't see ya. Yeah, I gave the song like an 8.
Yeah, I gave it a 7. It's a vibe.
And then the next song called Do You Miss Me? This one's... It's still good. Like, she's talented, but it's not as good. I gave this one a 7, though.
I like it. I can't give it a rating.
Yeah. All right. Well, I guess we can just get into it. Heroes and Villains by Metro Boomin.
If young Metro don't trust you, I'm going to shoot you.
What did you think about this album?
I didn't listen to it.
No! I gave it a 10. A fucking 10, dude. Yeah. Just like last year. In December, I had a 10 with the weekend.
He's about to get album of the year, and we a week in.
Yeah.
And now... All of these songs are really high for me. Yeah, a lot of them get better, like, after the song goes, because it's like, I don't know, maybe there's like a hero and a villain theme for each song or something. Let me just go to my favorite songs, I guess. Oh yeah, dude, Raindrops with Travis Scott was a really decent song. Travis Scott was the highlight of this whole album for me, basically. That's why I say that. So every Travis Scott song I instantly go to, and they're all 10s for me. Easy. But my favorite song of the whole album is this. It's called Trance. It's with Travis Scott and Young Thug. And usually I don't really like Young Thug's music that much, but I just love the way the song progresses, and then they repeat this one part, and it just sounds so good in the car. And yeah. All the sounds off this album are just crazy. Like, they always exceed expectations.
It's given what we thought Khaled album was gonna be.
Yeah, true. Oh yeah, I like this one. This song, I thought this was gonna be the first and only Hard Pass. It's with Young Thug by himself.
Yeah.
It's called Metro Spider. Because to me it just starts out so like weak. But this ended up being one of my favorite songs on the album. Because right now, you know, like me listening to this at work, dude, I was like, hell no, what the fuck? And I was gonna skip it. But I had to help a customer, so I couldn't skip it. He just turned the song up. There's a Weeknd and 21 Savage is on here a fuck ton too. I haven't really clicked any of his songs yet, but
I heard this one.
Yeah, I was gonna say
I like this one.
This one's one of the most interesting to me on the album.
And I hate when they redo old songs or whatever.
Oh, is that what this is?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Oh damn! I didn't even know that. Dude, this makes me want to grab a boombox and go to Diliana's window and she'll be like, get inside, what are you doing? No. But yeah, I mean, I would say the lowest part in this album would probably be these, and they're probably like 4 or 5s.
Yeah.
And everything else is like really high, like 8, 9, and 10, to be honest, each song.
Album of the year so far?
Oh yeah, easy. Mm-hmm. Well, it's not that hard, I guess.
Yeah.
Because it just came out. I'll bring a call. Hard pass.
Dang.
This was a hard pass. She brings me in a
piece. This, like, He dropped the album. I saw it after I heard this song.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And
damn.
I was like, I was going to check it out, but I just had a rough week, so.
I would have not listened to it.
Because I like every song that he's dropped so far. I think it's up one. I like, so.
It would have just been pointless for me to listen to it.
Get it? No pun intended.
Yeah, no pun intended, yeah. Bro, dude, yeah. So I had Angel break down every single line in this song.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie, bro. I think he's coming for Drake. There was a bunch of lines in there that, like, I feel like I've heard Drake use, but I feel like he does them better. Like he has some Beatle lines in here. Mm. And, dude, I got chills when, like, the way that Angel explained everything. I can't really do it now, but, like, because, you know, Drake says, oh, I got more slaps than the Beatles.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
That's cool. This motherfucker said, I'm walking across the road with the Beatles.
Mm.
And, you know, the fucking famous cover art of them walking, or he's like, I'm walking with the Beatles, or whatever. But the way he said it was just so fucking cold.
Did you listen to this?
I did, yeah. This song had, like, a lot of potential for me. And I thought it was... It's, you know, the whole shit in me thing is really clever. It's like, it's... I like it, but it's still only, like, a 5 for me. There's something missing that just I don't like.
I don't really care for the ASAP proof, but this was all right.
Yeah.
I wouldn't put it high on my list, but I gave it, like, a 7.
Yeah, this was, like, a 5 for me, but I do really like the song. I listened to that. Fallen. This was an 8 for me. Tell me, is it real
life, or is it only just a fantasy? Okay, I remember this, yeah. I said that this was a vibe.
Yeah, yeah, it's a vibe. This was an 8 for me. I don't know who the fuck this is, but hey, man, I'm gonna get to know him, I guess. I'm gonna start paying attention to when they release music, so.
I was like, okay. I usually don't like songs like this, but this one hits. Damn. I give him the credit.
So this song I wanted to listen to because 100 Gex is one of the biggest hyper-pop bands. And I've always been interested, when's the next hyper-pop song I'm going to like? Oh, it's not this one. Because this one's trash. This is a hard pass.
I like it. And I feel like it goes into the Chico for me, so.
Man, I do not like Lotto on this track, man. She fucked this song up. I like Glorilla a little bit. I'm starting to warm up to Glorilla.
You like Glorilla's voice, but not Lotto?
Yeah.
That's sad.
But it sounds like she's pretend. Like, she's not really a rapper. Like, she's just pretending.
My thing about Lotto is she can make really good music, but she always chooses the worst singles to come out with, in my opinion. So, this is a hard pass.
This song's a hard pass. This song's trash.
My thing about Glorilla is what you're saying about Lotto. Like, at least Lotto sounds like how she talks when she raps. Glorilla don't sound like how she raps when she talks. It's like, if you show me a picture of Glorilla and then give me a Glorilla song where you can hear this, I'd be like, okay, yeah, that's not the same.
I gave this a 4. I really tried to listen to this.
Morgan Rollin can do no wrong for me, so this is a 8 for me. He can do no wrong. I think he dropped if it's not an album, it's an EP or something. I listen to this and I love it.
Really?
It reminds me of Tuvlo. You're going, so I gotta stay high.
Oh,
all the
God.
Time.
I hate that song.
I love that song.
This was a hard pass.
Ain't no damn. Forth,
ain't no yeah, I can't stand Nas.
I thought it was cool. Disease, no, it's not Nas.
I can't stand him either way. However you say his name.
Yeah.
It's not for
I thought
me,
it was
bro.
Cool. It's not something that I'll listen to again at all. It's like a 5.
It's just so boring. They must have forgot
that I'm a new rapper. You listen to Suicide Boys?
I don't, but I know someone who does. And
I know somebody that does.
And he subscribed to our Patreon.
Ah.
And he's number, like, every year. He's listened to every fucking song, every, like, probably leak, everything of Suicide Boys.
Yeah, I got a friend that listened to Suicide Boys. I wouldn't know who they were if it wasn't for her, so.
This shit sounds all right, though, right now.
Yeah, I don't think I liked it, though.
I want to see how they come into it. They rap, right? Or what do they do?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, yeah. I don't like Danny Brown. I don't like this. It's the same shit for me.
You know Danny Brown?
Yeah. Now, Danny Brown is a very entertaining person. I love, and I've been to a Danny Brown concert before.
Yeah, I never knew who he was, and I saw him on Joe Rogan Experience because they was talking about UFC comedy and something else he was talking about. And I was like, he seemed like pretty cool.
I can almost see the appeal, but it's like the same people who – it's the same thing that like – or it's the same thing where like only people – like some people only like Eminem and they only listen to Eminem. And it's like that fast rapping thing.
Gotcha.
Danny Brown does that too, but it's just – it's also just so fucked up. It sounds like he's drunk the whole time as he's rapping, and it's just like a fever dream when you listen to it. You feel like you're just – like you're going on a fucking acid trip as you listen. It's just it sounds like a fucking Looney Tunes character rapping drunk. So this song started really good for me.
Still Life.
R.M. Anderson Paak. So I really, really liked the song at first, but then they lost it, and it kind of turned into like a hard pass. It's not a hard pass. But I give it like a 4. It started really strong for me, but just dropped off.
I like that. I gave it a 7, but Anderson Paak is like one of those people, you know? I'm still
alive. You think he'll ever be able to do something better than Silk Sonic?
No.
That project?
Yeah. And it's not his fault, because he probably could, but he just don't have the eyes.
Yeah, no, I agree with you. I agree. I think he kind of just he peaked.
Yeah, and it, a lot of that peak was to do with Bruno Mars. You know?
Yeah. Okay.
Like, really, musical people knew who Anderson Paak was, and then there was a lot of certain kinds of people that knew who Anderson Paak was, but then with him doing that with Bruno Mars, it spilled over into more of everybody knowing who Anderson Paak was. But I still don't think a lot of people are going to run to him, though, you know?
Yeah.
I think this is the last song I listened to.
Yeah, I was about to... Well, I started finding songs that I probably know. Actually, Metallica was the last one. I remember hitting there, and I was like, all right, I'm going to just find stuff that I know.
I wish I could pull up my release radar, but I don't think it's going to happen.
You want to try on here?
I can. Let me try this first, like the actual like web player. This sounds terrible.
I thought it was cool.
It sounds cool. I will give it that, but it's not like. It's interesting.
Yeah, I like it, but I don't love it. It's like a 6. What'd you think of this? Did you hear
it? It sounds really depressing for my taste. I don't think I'd ever be in a mood where I like this, but it does sound good.
The last song that she released was a hard pass. I think you actually liked it, and it was a hard pass for me. I like this one. I don't think I'd run back to it.
I'd give it a hard pass.
This one?
Yeah. Like, no one can do stuff like that now, you know?
This is good to me.
It's
like
a 7 for me.
This is the last one that I'm...
Oh, me too. Okay, that was one of the ones I was going to play on my release radar. What'd you think about this?
Hard pass, bro.
Damn, I like this.
This is hard pass, Kyle.
I like this.
Yeah, I
feel like she's like playing an homage to the 80s sound or 90s sound, whatever.
Yeah, but that's not her bag. Get back to your bag.
Bro, girls can be players too.
Yeah, they can, but I don't give a fuck.
See, this is the part that I like, when she's kind of like...
Yeah.
I like it. She does really good at what she's trying to do here.
Oh, I did wanted to click on this one. Just to say that it's given an angel. When me and the homies hit
the it's like Moses. It's Snoop Dogg, Ice Cube,
it's giving
E-40, and...
it's giving angel.
Too short.
Yeah. But yeah, Angel, I think he will really like that one.
I gave the Koi Larae a 5, by the way.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it was a
cool little 5 called Old Gone. And, you know, this is that type of music that I like.
Yeah.
I won't play too much of it, but he's one of my favorite artists that does music like this.
Yeah.
I gave it a 6. It's not great. Yeah, it's called Fentanyl. I don't know what's going on with Trippie Redd, though. I feel like he's not, like, an A-lister anymore. Like, he just kind of vanished from the mainstream. Like, he got blackballed or something.
Yeah.
This song doesn't sound that good on here, though. I give it, like, a 6.
Mm.
Get up to feed my cats. Yeah, that's my favorite part of the song. And I listen to Pain Never Lasts.
Hey. My grandma see me shining, she as proud as could be. Hey. I get paid to move around a couple thousand of feet. She only dying is free. I like this.
Oh, you know what? The song kind of gets weird though, like this. This is most of the song right here.
I think I actually might have scrolled across this section. I'm not sure.
Okay. I gave this song a 7.
I would really like this.
You want me to like it? No.
I could tell that I would probably get this like an 8 at least, just based off what I'm hearing so far. What's the name?
Kill Jasper.
Okay.
That's it for me.
This has been another episode of the Horror Pass Count.
I'm Cows with a K.
I'm Travi, but you gotta say it 2 times, and we'll see y'all next week. I promise. I'm gonna listen to more music. I mean, I had a rough week, man. You gotta understand it.
Yep.
I do wanna say though, the moment that my car gets fixed and my check hits the bank, I'm heading to the studio.
Ooh.
To the stew.
To the stew. You about to stew up?
I'm about to stew up something for y'all. Mm. But yeah, I did decide that I'm gonna work on an EP, probably release a single and go from there. A single or two.
I need to have like a background ad lib, like one, just like, yeah. No,
it can't be that though.
Yeah, it can't be that, but I'm trying to give you like an example or something. Yeah, like, yeah. I don't know, something stupid. But okay. We'll see. I definitely want to go to the studio with you one day.
Yeah,
you go. Yeah. It'd be so cool.
Yeah, we said we're going to do that. We're going to do that at some point.
Bet.
But yeah. All right. Well, we'll see y'all next week.
Like, comment, share, subscribe.
All that shit. And thank you.
Bye. Bye.